is no place to escape to.
This is the last street.
On the left.
That's when the cannibalism started.
My name is Marcus Parks. That shit's gonna be shown on the news when I die.
You little dookie eater. It just looks like, it really does look like you're eating a pile of shit.
It really does. It does. This is the life that I've chosen for myself and for my friends. Welcome to Last Stream on the Left, everybody. I'm Marcus Parks. This is
Ed Larson. I do not eat my own dookie. Marcus.
Not
does.
Anymore. That's no.
Not his own. And at home we have the COVID-ridden, plague-sick, cooties-bound Henry Zebrowski.
I want you to see my dedication to laughter. The fact that I am here. Danny DeVito's in the chat. I don't think it's the real Danny DeVito. It says I have my grandmother over to watch. I'm sorry that she's going to witness this.
Yeah.
But I am in a weakened state, but I also find that I'm strongest when I'm going to come from a corner.
Somebody brought a grandma. it's an early come from grandma. Oh,
anybody else got Paxlovid? I get this Paxlovid mouth.
It's the worst taste I've ever had in the worst sustained taste I've ever had in my mouth. It's there for as long as you take it, man.
Yeah, your mouth looks worse.
Yes, it is.
Actually,
I said something.
You know what? It's been a while. I think I've had a lot more. I've had a lot more experiences with Henry's mouth, the inside of Henry's mouth, than you have over recent years. Looking better.
Okay, good.
I think it's looking pretty good.
My tongue's a better color. My tongue's a better color. And I want to thank everybody who came out to the Animate Raleigh con that gave this to me.
Yeah.
But I want to say
Do you know who it was? Can you pinpoint the person?
Flower from Bambi.
Flower
from Bambi was there. They brought the entire cast of Bambi was there. He was in a full suit. He was.
Oh, the voice actors.
Yeah, the voice actors from Bambi. They were.
They're still alive.
Oh.
Yeah, I was. That's
like
alive? A 1940s movie, right? 50s tops.
What does the term alive mean? They were there. He had a suit on. He had basically only done Flower, and then he was like a doctor for the rest of his life. Like, he was one of those types of guys where he didn't do anything else.
Was he a child? Right?
Yeah, he was a child when he did Flower was the skunk, right?
Yeah.
Flower's the skunk.
Mm-hmm. And he was a child when he did it. He wasn't like 22.
No. He was a boy, but he was not a boy anymore. He's a very old man. And the whole time, I just imagined him sitting there just going like, there's no such thing as sailing on the moon. Back in my day, they used to take these sluts walking around here and put them in jail. He was very shocked. She saw nothing but cleavage. She's never seen a cosplayer before. You know?
Okay. So this is the cast of Bambi at an anime convention.
Yes. I'll never do. You don't know what it's like to do things you don't believe in for your country. The things I did on the beaches of Iwo Jima. You'll never fucking know. I'd kill Bambi's mother myself if I could. Deer are a vermin.
So was Flower the only person from Bambi? Was Thumper there or is Thumper dead?
No. Yeah, Thumper is
masturbated to death, right? Yeah.
Thumper was there. The aardvark, I think the aardvark, whichever one was ended up, they died on January 6th. They got shot by a police officer. And then, it was the body double of Belle was there. She was there.
Uh-huh. The body double? From the live action movie.
No.
Oh, like the person Wow.
The TV
the
show?
The Beauty and the Beast. So back in the day, they used to do animation doubles. So they would draw the boobies of somebody else.
Yeah,
the shapes of somebody else.
I've seen the Snow White stuff they did with that. Yeah.
Does she read a lot? Is she a reader like Belle?
Did you ask her? Did you ask her how much she read?
How many books she got?
I didn't want to.
Do you have a library?
No, but I did do my bit about the idea of like that whole, you know, the whole thing is about having sex with a giant warthog. It's all about finding a giant warthog. And, you know, like she loved his big barbed penis and she loved the fact that his like maws smelled like blood. And he was an asshole.
Yeah.
He was, you know, like, asshole.
He's a fucking asshole.
Yeah.
And she still wants to have sex with him like he's Mickey Rourke. So Matt says cinnamon candies help with the Paxlovid mouth.
Cinnamon candies.
Yeah.
Ugh, it's, that's what's going to be good for you. Your life is in the tubes.
Yeah, who eats cinnamon candy? I don't eat cinnamon candy.
This isn't
candy.
My fucking...
You know what? It's not Henry's mandate. It's not cinnamon's mandate. It's my fucking mandate. It's my mandate.
Take the mic.
I'm taking the fucking mic. It's my mandate. And today, we got some... There's some bad shit coming up later. You're not going to like it. Right. You're not going to enjoy it. We got a very special edition of which one of these do you like the most? And
that's
I got
to
say,
okay.
This is one, Henry, this one's for you. But we're not going to get to that just yet. We're going to start off with something lighthearted.
All right.
We're going to start off with, it's a workplace accident. Let's just see it.
It's lighthearted.
Get your fucking arms ripped off. Dang.
Let's see one more time. One more time. One more time. Let's
keep it simple.
Oh, that poor bastard.
He survived.
What?
It was an electrical. There was some sort of electrical. Electric grapes.
Oh,
yeah.
Man. Which I love Electric Grapes' third album.
Yeah, dude. Electric Grapes could have been Led Zeppelin. It could have been Led Zeppelin, but they didn't do it.
No, he was a Brazilian TV reporter. Eventually, he went on to serve in Congress in Brazil for many years.
Oh, so he lived.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he lived. Ooh, no, I'm not showing live death. That's the guy who lived. He had an eye.
One of my favorite sounds in the world is the involuntary noises a man makes in pain. Like, it's one of my favorite. Elena Rothney asks, how does Marcus feel about his birthday coming up in 2 days?
I'm feeling fine about it. It's fine. I'm not a big birthday guy. I don't really care one way or another, but, you know, yeah, my birthday's coming up. And
how old are you going to be?
41.
Oh, who cares about 41?
Yeah, 41. It's
nothing counts until 50. Yeah.
Yeah,
I got my 40th coming, but nothing counts until 50, man. You're strong, dog. But 41 also, it means nothing.
Yeah,
41 means nothing.
It's fine.
Nobody.
But I thank you for your concern.
Yeah.
For my birthday.
Oh, here, Bush Kush 420 says, my uncle swears that cinnamon candies can make a breathalyzer test inaccurate. Which sounds like
the ramblings of a drunk man.
The drunken uncle. Yeah, yeah. That's uncle wisdom.
Yeah.
That's what your uncle says. Yeah.
Yeah, you also shouldn't drive a car when you're hammered. You know, the cinnamon candies do not.
But if you have to, and I mean if you have to, because you know you got to like about once a month, you know you have to. You know when you have to. You know what I mean when you have to.
What if you just really want to?
Cinnamon.
What if you just like I stuck up on the cinnamon.
It's the cinnamon.
I watch up on the. Don't worry, officer. I have my cinnamon, and I am as sober as Hunter Biden. Ready to go, man.
And that right there was a prime example of some of Henry's expert character work.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
He's an expert character actor. We know that you. Your time in Murder Fist. Expert character actor.
Yeah, more of like a straight man type of guy.
But you do great characters.
Thank you.
I love
really
your characters. Percival the Cat, one of my favorites.
I mean, you know, he's an unbelievable.
It's an unbelievable character. You've really reached down from the depths. You brought out something beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. But
you're good.
The thing
you're a good actor.
You're Thank a great you. Actor.
Thank
but the
you.
Thing is about the two of you, you could use work.
Always.
You could always use work. We can always get better. And I've got a woman that's going to teach you how to do characters.
Oh, thank God.
Don't fucking do it. Whatever, man.
Hello. Again? Very nice. I was creating an Italian character when the melodic type voice quality was born for me. That's so good.
I did take this class.
Mama actually, pizza.
I did take
that does
class.
Not compute. Beat it again. I do not understand the data. Okay. Hey, okay.
This is.
And let's get it over here in the sky, all right?
That's me as a little boy.
I don't like that.
Get out there and perform.
And you too can have fun with ventriloquism.
Thank you, Found Footage Fest.
Yeah, ventriloquism only works if, like, you can see both people at the same time. She's just making a voice for the puppet.
Well, that's the thing. So you got to learn how to do the voices first, then you bring the puppet into it.
Also, I would have preferred to see the rest of the tape.
It's so good. I want to wish you a happy birthday. A happy birthday, Marcus. And I want to wish you a happy birthday.
This is very, very good. I would like to see the rest of the class where she taught me the rest of my accents.
I would imagine she went beyond Italian. Yeah. I'm willing to bet.
There's multiple Italians you can do. You know, it's definitely like, hey, get over here. I love the, high-pitched Italian.
You're talking about Nona? Yeah, there's a Nona with a,
hey, why you leaving me, Beanie?
And then you have the, then there's Italian, New York. There's New York, American Italian. And then there's, but Jersey and New York are actually very different.
What's the difference?
I do believe that. I think that if you do listen, because especially if you go Southern Jersey, it sounds more like Baltimore, right? It sounds like that fucking garbage.
Balmer.
Right? And then if you, Balmer, right? You get up there because I got some bullshit on that last time we did a New Jersey series because it was mostly Southern Jersey and they actually sound like you're from Pennsylvania, which is very confusing. It doesn't make any fucking sense.
On the west side, not the east side.
Yeah.
The east side, they still sound like North Jersey. The Atlantic City fuckers, you know? The Toms River still sounds like Newark.
Yeah.
Chupacabra, how far does Henry's chair go back?
And he's gone. It goes back to last week. And my favorite Italian, though, Henry, is the high-pitched Italian. You do such a good high-pitched Italian. Can we hear a little bit?
Hey, what are you doing? Why you gotta be? Why you gotta be? Why? Who fucking is touching what I'm on?
I'm fucking, oh, God.
His goddamn pizza's all full of glass.
Yeah.
Great. Again, that woman wasn't bad. I like that. I liked her performance. I loved her robot.
Yeah, her robot does not compute. If you have your robot ventriloquist. Yeah, I've never seen a robot ventriloquist dummy.
Yeah, no, what's good is you just put a box up there and you call it the dummy. You don't have to work the hand. You just do the voices.
That is true.
Yeah, you're just talking about acting. Now we're back to acting. He's doing ventriloquism.
Well, you're talking about acting. I'm going to show you a guy that's real as fuck.
Hell yeah.
This guy's real. Like, when I'm talking about he's real, I'm saying this guy is real. He's spitting truths. Mm-hmm. He's telling you who he is every time, and he does it in about 5-10 seconds, tells you everything you need to know about this guy. Eric, let's
see. Is this like Cat Williams? Is this going to be Cat Williams? We're going to get into this? We're going to talk about this?
I hope them aliens are real so that I have more things to fuck. Oh.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. These are short ones today.
Yeah, I got some short ones, some long ones. You know, we're going to go back and forth. Which one of these do you like the most is, those are really long.
Okay, good.
Oh, shit. Gnarly Charlie says power's out in South Jersey right now from the storm because there's a big old storm happening right now, apparently.
Oh, yeah.
Gnarly
dark with the six-pack peak viewing right now. Fuck yeah, dog.
Polar vortex.
Polar vortex is coming in, which doesn't make any fucking sense. Why do we assume if extraterrestrials are real that they would even be fuckable? Have you looked at all of this current? We're going to talk about it tomorrow on Side Stories. Mm-hmm. Have you looked at all in the Miami alien shit?
No.
I haven't looked in the Miami alien shit. So you're saying that there's no orifices?
Dude, well, it's because in the end, like, why would they necessarily be humanoid? Why would they have the fuckable parts? right? I don't think a fucking alien cares about giving you a hand job. I don't think they want it. I don't think they care about your pleasure. I don't think that they can use their little slit of a mouth to suck your dick. And they don't have buttholes. Like, even the other ones.
But you could even jerk off onto anything.
Yeah, but then that's... It might as well be a lamp.
And that's what makes it you human.
Yes. It might as well be this copy of Final Events by Nick Redfern.
Oh, Nick Redfern.
Oh, good plug, yeah.
He usually has better cover art than that. I mean, that's nice, but...
He's sliding down since the Men in Black days, but we're getting there.
It looks self-published.
Yeah, you can see the gloss on it. That's some self-published gloss.
It is very much self-published, but have you? You got to get it. I can't wait to go into this Miami alien thing because a lot of kids were fighting, and I mostly think that was the issue: is that a lot of children were fighting.
Yeah, it's a street brawl in Miami. It happens all the goddamn time.
And some say there's an alien involved in the street brawl.
I'll show you tomorrow. Oh. Aaron says, Henry, do the squonk. I was talking about this week on Tears of a Clown when we were talking about most fuckable cryptids, about how what's nice about the squonk is that you can just push it down and fucking rail on it.
What's a squonk? Can you tell me? I don't know what a squonk is.
You're going to have to put up a picture. It is a thing that is just a little fat-bellied, squiggly, this thing.
Oh, yeah. That's so cute.
And if you just push it down and start railing on it from the front or the back, and you just hear it going,
well, it's
like,
got that prolapse thing going on.
Yeah.
It's got the sleeve. Yeah. It's got the sleeve that you can bunch up like it's a big unforeskinned. Is there such a thing as a vagina with a foreskin?
I mean, there is now. It's a squonk.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Why is it always so sad?
It's just a hog.
It's a sad, creature.
You can just say you can also easily push down a Vietnamese pot-bellied pig and fuck that.
Mm-hmm. You can.
It's the same thing.
Wow, these are great.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love a squonk.
You could absolutely Sasha Gray style face pound one of these things.
Yeah.
And it would be fine.
I feel like you could fuck any part of it.
That's yeah, the saying. Fold, like kind of fold it over. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But then by the time you're doing that, you're kind of bored.
Squonk.
Well, if you're just trying to fuck it, then it's like, obviously, you should be in jail.
Yeah.
I mean, why? It's a squonk.
Oh, Elizabeth DeAngelo says the clitoral hood is the equivalent of the vagina foreskin. I'm a medical student.
Oh.
But if you ever have ones that are really, 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 really long.
But you can't feel... inches. Foreskins, like, they're not like, you know, you can't feel them, right?
Yeah, there's feeling in foreskin.
There's feeling in the foreskin?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, definitely. Yeah that's
I'll
why.
Never know.
Yeah. Well, that's why we'll never know. Apparently, you get it both ways.
Oh, really? Like,
yeah, we were robbed.
Yeah, we were robbed.
We were robbed.
Quite a bit of sexual
pleasure. I'm glad to not clean my penis as often as they have to.
You know what? I think I would have enjoyed it. I would have really enjoyed keeping my foreskin clean.
Really?
Yeah. I think it would have been one of those, like, fun daily things. I've got an extra 2.5 minutes.
2.5 minutes, dude, every day? You're busy.
I got two and a half minutes.
Yeah. For your makeover, we're get the fucking foreskin extenders.
Ooh.
And then a part of the makeover is that now you have a full-on foreskin.
That is a full-on surgical procedure that I'm not prepared in any way whatsoever to engage in.
Remember, a little hat.
You know the thing.
I'll put a hat on.
Your penis.
It's the garter belt that goes around your. It's the garter belt that goes around your thigh and it connects to the top of your penis and it pulls down the foreskin. It's a natural weight scenario.
Now I've seen it. I don't want to do it.
It probably only takes months.
I don't think it's like this is it. You can make it happen, dude. You're not going to do it for our Patreon subscribers. You're not going to do it for our fans. You're not going to do it for our YouTube subscribers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. If we reach 5 million Patreon subscribers.
Oh, man, it's going to happen.
5 million Patreon subscribers. At minimum, $1 each. At minimum, $1 each.
Oh, my God. Henry, how much money do you have?
I will wear one for a day. I'll wear it for a day. I'll wear it for a day. A full day. And I'm not going to show you that I'm wearing it. You have to take it on faith that I'm wearing it. I'm a man of my word. I am. Mm-hmm. I'll
want to at least see the mark of it. Slacking off, Marcus complains about having no time, but you know he would make time.
Yeah, of course. That's what I mean. I'd make time. It's 2.5 minutes. I'd make how to regrow foreskin.
Oh, wow.
We're going to. I feel like, again,
it's
vitamin
only,
E.
You got to make, number one, make the decision.
Okay.
Number two, call your mother.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Call your senator.
We're talking a lot about sex right now. Mm-hmm. I'm talking a ton about it.
I'm just talking about biological parts of a man.
Of course, of course, of course. But these things, these are the sorts of things that you get in sexual education. Yeah, oh yeah, eHarmony knows how to fucking regrow a foreskin. Of course they do.
Oh yeah, of course.
These are the types of things that you want covered in sexual education. What is a foreskin? Why don't we have it? What's missing? What's wrong with us? I'm going to show you a sex education video right now.
Oh.
It's the doctors.
From Ireland.
Ooh.
Where they do things a little differently.
I feel like, yeah, getting an Irish
now,
sex teacher.
While the sperm is coming into the man's penis, the woman's body is getting ready to receive the sperm. It's amazing, you know, how God made it. Because while they're making love and being happy together, the woman feels her vagina becoming kind of slippery inside, so that the penis can easily slip in and out.
I've heard about this.
Yeah, so I've heard about it. I read a book about this.
Into
once.
Her vagina, gives her the sperm. She has the sperm.
Wait now.
Then
wait.
The penis slips out, and that's all. And that's called sexual intercourse. Some people call it having sex. So the man passes the sperm to the woman, and now his sperm is in her.
Troy Aikman.
Maybe you're wondering if a mistake could be made and a man could pass water instead of semen and sperm when having sexual intercourse. But that can't happen because there's a valve which closes to stop the urine coming when sexual intercourse is taking place.
I don't know.
I've never tried.
Now, possibly you're saying to yourself, oh, I'll never do that. It's awful.
Hey.
Because, you know, when you hear about it first, it sounds very strange. But God has made it really lovely. An exciting and pleasant feeling.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's not lovely every time.
You know?
There has been some reported cases of it not being lovely.
Yeah.
It's just something about
sometimes it weren't lovely at all.
Especially in
it's
Ireland.
Calling it lovely, you know? It's that term. It's just like saying, like, it is absolutely. She might as well be saying scrummy. Absolutely scrummy. You wouldn't even believe it's slickness. There's a slickness that causes the penis. And I know it's not. That's immature. That's immature to talk about the fact that there's a penis sliding it out. That's not funny. You know what is funny?
What's it?
Imagining that woman.
Yeah.
Getting it.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah,
because I imagine her just going like, "Oi, oi, hey!" Like, I
go ahead and try and pee in me. I know you can. I know you. Your switch is flipped.
I know about
you
the valve.
You can't fill me up. I'm
here. I know about the valve. I don't care what you say.
Fill me with it. Fill me with the urine. Take the valve. Fill me with your urine.
Your Irish gold.
There, fucking Effie, why don't you brace yourself? I'm going to try to break the valve. All I want to know is piss inside of your guts. Because you don't think that people can't pee?
When they're hard?
I mean, you can pee when you're hard.
Of course you can pee when you're hard.
Yeah, sometimes you're only hard because you got to pee.
Yeah.
A little piss hard willy. That's what my coach used to call him.
Okay, so
football coach,
piss hard Willie.
Piss hard Willie.
You're only hard because you have to pee.
Yeah, he says he has to. In order to, my football coach said, in order to have sex with his wife in the morning, he used to have to drink a gallon of water before he went to sleep, so we'd have a piss hard Willie in the morning. I was a freshman in high school.
My football coach also told me some many sexually inappropriate things, but. The piss hard Willy. So having to urinate in the morning gave him an erection.
Yeah.
And so he'd go and urinate. Would he urinate before having sex with his wife, or would he have sex with his wife and pretend like the piss was his cum?
I would think that he would just have sex with his wife and not pee or cum and then just leave and then pee.
What are we doing then? Like, literally, what are we doing then?
Making your wife happy.
Yeah. No, you
gotta piss first. You got it.
You'll lose the piss hard willy if you piss first.
Yeah. If the piss is the only thing that's filling your dick. Mm-hmm. Although that wasn't.
You ever wake up with an erection and then you go pee and it's gone?
But that's mostly just to do with me like waking up.
Yeah.
Yeah. And once I'm peeing, my penis knows that there's nothing else gonna happen here because I gotta you know, get my day started.
Yeah, and you piss hard, Willie.
If you honestly, if I
wake up having to pee, I'm never hard.
Oh,
if you really have to use a piss hard Willie to have sex with your wife, I think you should start looking at divorce. No. I think if pee is the only thing fueling your eroticism and it's not outside of your body, like it's in actual inflation, I think it's actually healthier to be pissed. I think it's healthier to be pissing on each other and liking it versus using the piss as erection fuel.
No, I think what it is I think this man is a good husband.
Yeah, that's because what I think too.
Because this man, he's a
bad
man who,
coach. Bad, horrible coach. We were a bad team.
Does a good husband tell a 15-year-old this? These secrets about his wife?
That's a bad football coach.
Well. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, but yeah. Out of all the other coaches, he's probably the best.
Yeah. But I would say that this is a man who has a hard time achieving erections in the morning, but his wife enjoys morning sex. Some people are morning people. Some people are afternooners. Some people are nighters. She likes it in the morning, so he's doing his best to have sex with his wife when she wants it.
Yeah.
And he's doing
good. I don't know if he is. I'm going to go straight up and say, I don't know if he is having sex with his wife. I think that he's lying to a 15-year-old.
I think it's a room of 15-year-olds. And I will say one nice thing about him. Of all of our football coaches, he had the least amount of DUIs.
Wow.
Yeah, actually.
But again, is that good or bad?
The one that I that was the least bad one also had the least amount of DUIs.
Yeah. See, yeah. I think that helps. Yeah. You know, Poopy
got it good. In Ireland, they call it circumcised hide. That's funny.
Now that we're here in peepee land.
Peanut trans mask here on testosterone. I have foreskin on my clit. Damn.
Wow.
Nice.
Damn.
Nice. We're here in peepee land now.
It's a double hood.
Here in peepee land, which means we're in the bathroom.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I honestly got to pee real bad. I've been drinking water all day because I got all this garbage mouth.
Yeah.
All of this talk is driving me insane.
Well, you better not leave, because we're about to do, which one of these do you like the most?
Ooh.
Bathroom edition. Did I say the least? All right, well, then we're going to go with least this time.
Which one do you like the least?
Which one of these do you like the least? We're going to have the bit.ly.
Should
we rank them?
Well, we're going to have the fans vote.
Oh, okay,
yeah,
great.
We'll have a bit.ly up. We'll put it in the chat. We'll have the fans vote out of these three. Which of these do you like the least? Bathroom edition.
Which do you like the least?
This is the bathroom in which someone has died.
Okay.
And so there.
Is that blood?
That's blood and maggots.
Okay. Oh, God. And this is inside a home?
This is inside a home. This is from
it might be a restaurant with the bleach right next to it.
It's a home.
It's a home.
Yeah, it's a home. Well,
that's not good. No. I forget that to a lot of things, blood is food.
Mm-hmm.
So if you spread out a lot of blood, like truly, like it is a way for these things to live.
Maggots are like, really going to be into it. Yeah. Yeah. This is from an Instagram by a bunch of guys who do like crime scene cleanups, unattended deaths.
Okay.
And they also clean out hoarder houses, which will be.
I think that's a show I can't watch all the time.
Well, the hoarder houses are going to be the next two. And which of these do you like the least? Bathroom edition.
Okay.
Let's go for the next one.
Let's see what happens here.
Last one wasn't even bad. It was just maggots. That shit. Oh, I know that is literally all liquid shit. Yeah.
It's all diapers.
I love the sexy TikTok music. I feel like I'm in
splat. The splatter goes everywhere. The splatter's very gross.
It's because at some point you're squatting over the toilet and you're just shitting directly.
Oh, those are all diapers.
Yeah, they're all diapers.
Those are diapers, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and it's right next to the food pantry as well.
Oh, you know, the thing with throwing out diapers, if you throw them out, you don't get to keep them.
No. And that's the worst part. That's
a real good point.
Especially for all the diapers. I'm on the diaper resale websites each day, and it is just murder. You're leaving money on the table if you're not fucking keeping your diapers. Kelly Slice has had 10,000% Henry is peeing in a water bottle right now. I honestly wish I could.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, let's go to the
after
last
this
one.
Vote, I'm going to run and pee when we do this vote.
All right. All right. Cool.
We'll vamp.
This last one, I like to call this one the scooper.
All right.
Number three.
Okay, good.
I hate when they have a name.
That's like the leaf. That's like the leaf. Right? That's the idea?
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
This might be the worst. The I think this is the worst
one already. Yeah. Yeah, this is the worst one.
Just listen for the sounds. Listen for the sounds. Listen.
Oh, my God, Marcus.
Such an audiophile.
Listen, listen.
Oh.
No. Oh, my God.
But it's even better when the second plops this on the first.
Me,
listen.
This makes you want to die. Shh, 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 shh. I can't. I'm going to die. I can't. This is so bad.
Just burn down the house.
The third one's the best one. The third plop is the best plop. It's progressive plops.
I just don't understand why even clean it.
I wouldn't even buy. I would not purchase that house. There is no way. You would have to burn that house to the fucking ground and just rebuild it.
The poll is open on our Vimeo chat. So go to the Vimeo chat and get the link there and tell us which one do you like the least. Is it maggot bathroom, diaper bathroom, or the scooper?
Scooper. By far, yes.
Yeah, Scooper's running the ass. Because everything else I feel like could be cleaned like with some sort of like brush broom, you know? Like,
yeah.
I feel like that, like everything else like has like potential to get better again.
Yeah.
But that is just the memory of that shit log in that toilet.
I mean, it's not even a log. I mean, it was a full bowl that was impacted. It was impacted
someone
in
like,
there.
They like pushed it in there.
Yeah, like they pushed it down it like with a like maybe a press.
And they
of
were
some
choosing
sort.
Not to pee in there. It seems like.
Yeah. Oh yeah, because that was just full solid.
And there was no water.
It was very consistent as well.
My expert view on it is that they had since cut the water off. The water had drained out of that toilet. They continued to shit on top of shit because that was all liquid shit. That was all liquid shit. And it slowly but surely dissolved into a form of cake like parfait.
Yes.
And then I feel is very
turned
difficult.
Turned into Arby's.
It did. Very quick. Yeah, you could. They froze that and then shaved it. It'd be Arby's. The Max Beard. One of my cousins used to hoard diapers. Why? I want to know why. I honestly do want to know why. Girl Goyle, I used to. Why?
Oh, okay. I see someone's about to bring up it does resemble somewhat a nice British pudding.
Is that a taco lava cake?
British pudding? That is a lava cake.
Is that a lava cake? Lava cake. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Very much for.
Ooh, toilet lava cake.
Very much so. That is the name of the episode. Gurgoyle, I used to be a worker for someone who was obese and blind and had to use a toilet paper wand to wipe and wipe so hard she would fling shit on the ceiling and wouldn't know it because she was blind. But not nose blind, friend, because I believe I know we have blind listeners. I think that most blind people understand when they're flinging shit around because they have better hearing and can hear the plops on the ceiling.
Yeah.
And I think that they know that they can feel the shit. You know, if you're pulling shit out of you and you can feel it slide and slap against the walls, I feel like, or maybe I'm sensitive. Maybe I'm like the princess of the pea. And I can't, I notice too much. I'm an empath.
Yeah. Yeah, some people have very little understanding of their surroundings or their bodies, and sometimes...
You think that it's ADHD? Penny Breadful, I'm a therapist, and I work with compulsive hoarding. It's always trauma. Yeah, they're not hoarding out of celebration.
No, it's always trauma. Yeah, I've seen so many episodes of Hoarders. I watched episode after episode after episode of Hoarders. Oh, yeah. I love that
show. Like, in a case, you know, and organized, you know, like that's what happy people hoarders
do. There was one guy that was this very successful brain surgeon who had four houses of like super nice shit and was all extraordinarily expensive, but it was still hoarding. And
it's
the
hoarding,
final
but what is the difference between hoarding and collecting? It is, are you Jay Leno?
Yeah, if you have a curio cabinet, it's not hoarding.
Final results of the poll. We have maggot, 15%.
Mm-hmm.
Diaper, 26%.
Okay.
Scooper, 57% the least favorite.
Yeah.
Come.
Yes. Mm-hmm. No one coming. No one is remotely coming, even thinking about it. It has set me back. That video has made me not good anymore.
Cool.
I'm not feeling well.
Do you not have to pee anymore?
Well. No, I feel just devoid of feeling.
Yeah.
And I am nauseous.
Yeah.
The term is nauseous. And I have to go to the bathroom.
Okay. Do you want to go to the bathroom?
Go to the bathroom.
I will have to do it at some point.
At
I
some point.
You have 25 minutes
let's,
to make
let's
it.
See. Maybe this next video will inspire some sort of feelings. Because I wanted to give a nice palate cleanser.
Wait a second, Marcus. I'm saying this. There's a whole Daredevil subplot, apparently, about being blind and him needing to shit. Is there a whole Daredevil has to shit subplot?
Where's the bathroom?
I don't know. What do you mean a subplot, a Daredevil subplot where he has to shit?
I mean, he could shit.
Is that where he
in what? What run? Mark Waid?
I tell you how to,
Bendis?
Even
Miller?
I know how to fight. Like,
Brubaker?
In a hotel room. I had this happen to me the other day where I was in a hotel room and it was super dark in there. And I walked around and I couldn't figure out where the toilet was. And then I looked down and I literally had to touch underground and I found the rim of a toilet in the dark.
Yeah.
Oh, Poopy says I was lying. That's okay. Not Poopy. You can't lie here. Okay?
In the okay, in the Netflix show.
Yeah,
yeah.
You gotta be careful, Henry. Man, that's how Saget passed away. You know, you gotta when you're in those hotel rooms, take your time.
Well, I take baby steps. Yeah. I feel around with my foot. You don't do that.
Don't get
I literally
cocky.
At night when I'm walking around a hotel room at night, I do this. Where like I go like.
I do that in my normal because I'm always worried I'm going to step on one of my dogs.
Yeah.
That is what I do at night. Like, I make like a, you know what they call it? The I think it's called the manta ray shuffle, which you do in Florida. You know what I'm talking about, Eddie.
Yeah.
At the beach where you're supposed to shuffle your feet because it keeps you from getting bit.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know what I'm talking about?
I do know what you mean. Yes. But it's not really manta ray. It's horseshoe crabs are the problem.
Yeah.
And man of war. Those will get you.
Horseshoe crabs. They hiss, don't they?
Man of war is going to get you either way.
Yes.
Anyway, getting fucking. Britt Wavy, somebody at my high school did that. Just kept shitting in the secret gym toilet for months, and I had the misfortune of discovering it because the smell was so bad, I had to see what it was. I feel like more often than not, the water goes out, or they cut the water off to a certain part of a house, and then they're just shitting on fucking shitting dry.
Scooper, that's the third Manning brother, right?
Scooper Manning.
Oh, I thought Zambonis. That was Sarah. I thought that was Sarah Palin's nanny.
Well, let's get a good palate cleanser in here. Let's see this beautiful, beautiful ode to coffee.
Oh man,
wasn't say the last it, thing an ode to coffee?
1, 2, 3, 4. I love coffee. I love tea. I love the job.
Look at that rug.
Coffee and tea. As an age today.
The Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Boy. I love coffee. Sweet and hot.
They actually debuted this on Epstein's plane. It's really nice.
This is white with a hard H.
What?
What?
What? It makes me angry.
So few people have anal beads as a necklace.
Man, those, that pair of sandals on that man was fucking criminal. Those are the worst sandals I have. Go back.
Actually, I didn't notice the sandals at all. I was too focused on the head.
Love sandals. The Birkenstocks?
Sandals on that, yes. Those
What's
are
wrong?
Absolutely.
They are tight. Those look like his wife's sandals.
Worst. Those are literally, that's worse than the Scooper video. Those sandals are absolutely horrifying.
You don't like Birkenstocks.
Those are not Birkenstocks, my friend. Those are something else. That is something worse.
He's wearing socks, too.
Those are Birka socks.
Birkenstocks. Oh, God. Oh, wow. Uncle Sherry, my grandpa used to sing this to us as grandkids. This really takes me back, but I don't know if that's a good thing. You know, it's nice. Yeah. My father used to sing the a lot of horrible songs.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you dirty little pollock. Does your mother know you're out with a hole in your britches and your dickie sticking out?
You know, it's like all that.
Yeah,
you used to have a lot of them.
As I sit in my cell with my fingers dipped in shit and the shadow of my ding-dong on the wall, as the prisoners pass are shoving peanuts in my ass and the guards are playing ping-pong with my balls.
I don't know that one.
It lives in here.
I've never heard anything close. I don't even know the tune. Like,
thank you.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it's my grandfather. My father used to sing it. It's a very, it's a Lifshultz tradition.
That's nice, though. You see, that's where you get your sense of humor.
Yeah, that is nice. That is nice. Well, as people know, I just came back from England. Went there.
Yeah, oh, congratulations. Mr. Fancy Man.
I went to visit family. I went to visit family.
Let's take it back. Take England back.
Let's visit family. And I've heard people say, is Marcus trolling us when he talks about how much he loves British food? I'm not. I love that shit. It's wonderful. No, I had so many.
You are not.
I can vouch.
That man has enjoyed more British things than Prue. Like, you like shit on there, man. You like the worst food on the face of the goddamn planet.
I like it. I like it a lot. It's so tasty.
It's surprisingly good.
Yeah. But you know what I really love?
It's better. It's better since the last time we had went.
It's better. It's good. It's good. But you know what I really love? The British lamb. I love lamb. Who loves lamb?
He does love lamb.
Do you love lamb?
I love lamb. I love lamb.
Okay, so we're going to watch this.
Remember when we went through? Over our Christmas break, we made lamb like three separate times. And the one thing is that I will say, if you don't notice, Marcus, is that do you find that if you eat lamb for like three or four meals, that your pee smells different?
I'm sure that's true.
The only time I've eaten lamb for three or four meals is when I've been in Iceland, because lamb's like mostly what you eat there.
Yeah.
But everything smells like sulfur there, so I'm not sure what my pee smelled like.
It was like my pee became gamey.
Ooh.
Is it supposed to?
That sounds nice.
Thick.
That sounds real nice.
Just different. Mm. It smelled just different.
Strong?
I know. Yes. Yes.
We're going to watch this British lamb commercial about four times in a row.
Okay.
And I want you guys, after you watch it, tell me, do you want lamb more?
Okay.
Less? Or is your desire for lamb the same as when the video began?
Four times?
I'm very hungry.
I'm starving.
More?
I'm less. Starving. I could eat lamb. I want lamb. I love lamb.
Let's go.
All right.
Here we go. Grady says this.
What's the matter with your British lamb? It's ever so easy. Because it's ever so quick. Chop, chop. Chop, chop.
Chops.
What about a bit of British lamb? It's ever so easy. Because it's ever so quick. Chop, chop. Chop, chop.
Chops.
What about a bit of British lamb? It's ever so easy. Because it's ever so quick. Chop, chop. Chop, chop.
Chops.
What about a bit of British lamb? It's ever so easy. Because it's ever so quick. Chop, chop. Chop, chop.
Chops.
More. Less. Or the same.
Polls are open.
Polls are open. Polls are open. I actually do, but in the Vimeo, more, less, or the same.
I feel unchanged.
I feel unchanged.
Yeah.
I feel unchanged. I like it just as much as I did before, and I wanted it just as much as before. But truly, you know what's weird is I'm kind of mad because the idea of I don't think lamb should be cooked quick unless
it takes a long time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless you do it really on a grill, but then it has to be chops, right?
And
you have
thin.
To cut it up like.
Yeah, no. Well, thin. Those are obviously very thin cuts of lamb.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, very
what was
thin.
The first? What was the first lamb dish? I couldn't recognize it.
I don't know. Let's watch it again.
It was some lump. Oh God, we're watching it again. Grady says I used to make lamb bone broth for work. Oh my God.
So quick.
It's a scooper all over again.
Circles.
It's probably
that. It feels
like it's going fast.
It's ever so quick.
No, the first one.
That one. What
is that? That's interesting. Curls.
It looks like a cock.
Yeah. Lamb curls.
Yeah, that looks bad, dude. You know what that might be? That might be some kind of pastry with lamb inside.
Oh,
of it.
No, that's not pastry.
Like a lamb Wellington.
No, that's not pastry. That's just lamb. I don't know what part of the lamb that is, but it's a curled part of the lamb.
Could be a neck.
Look at this godforsaken meal. Four boiled potatoes. Pile of just pee. Ugh, I can't see my brother.
Yeah, four boiled potatoes. Lamb, bunch of peas. If only that pea was mushy. Oof. Mm-hmm.
Is that? Are these lamb swirls? Lindsay Necropolis says my dog shits different when she gets lamb. Which also is I can vouch for it because Wendy's shit is definitely different when she eats venison. Grady, okay. I used to make lamb bone broth for work, and I would drink several cups a day. My piss smelled like a herd of sheep.
Fun.
That is just wild. What
stay
kind
away
of
from collies.
Guys, that is sheep.
Yes, yes.
Y'all fart a lot when you sleep.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Apparently, I thought I didn't, but then my wife was like, she farted in bed, and I was like, hey, what are you doing farting in bed? And she's like, you fart all the time. I was like, oh, okay, you do it.
Honestly, Eddie, if I was going to be racist about you, mm-hmm. I'd say you definitely farted in your sleep.
Well, I know
you know, just from looking at you, just from looking you walking down the street, as much as I love you, I could. Yep, that guy farts in his sleep. Absolutely, that guy farts in his sleep. That guy has sleep apnea. That guy loves ham. Definitely, I'm already nailing it for certain. He's a hot hugger.
Do you think that if farting in your sleep could be sleep crapnea? Sleep crapnea.
Sleep crapnea. I like
save
that.
It.
Sleep crapnea. That's,
save
that's
it. We're doing a show.
I mean, we're doing
a
show. I mean, well, before we get to the reason why I asked that question,
you know why? I thought Marcus. It's so weird, Marcus. That's leading to something.
Yeah, it was leading to something. But the poll that we have here, poll at 38%. Makes them want lamb more.
More!
Interesting.
At 21%, less.
Less!
Interestingly, quite possibly for the British Lamb Council.
Mm-hmm. I gotta pee so bad.
Save it for the lamb. Save it for the lamb.
40% unchanged.
The unchanged yep. have it. The
so
unchanged
absolutely
have it.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
So it did
it
absolutely
was like
nothing
happened.
For them.
Absolutely nothing happened.
Yeah, it's like that fucking that out sick that fucking song. That song is incredible. I love the song.
Yeah. Chop 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 chop.
What's the best bit of British lamb?
I don't want to do it anymore.
Cause it's episode crazy.
I have to pee so bad. I got Paxlovid mouth. I watched The Scooper. I'm nauseous. Devlin Desad says, I work with a Christian lady at a gas station who wouldn't eat lamb because Jesus was a lamb. That's not true. It's symbolic. And also, the lamb was then fed as Easter. It's an entire symbolic meal.
Mm-hmm. I don't think she paid a whole lot of attention.
Yeah.
So the farting in the bed.
Thank you.
I got a solution for you.
All right.
I got a one. It's called a cork.
Let's see it.
I'm the cork.
It's the problem in the marriage bed that no one likes to talk about. Maybe that's why they call it
He's
silent,
asleep.
But deadly.
He's a fucking
well,
thing.
Now
he has
there's
no
a
idea.
Real solution to a very real problem. Introducing the Better Marriage Blanket. On the outside, the Better Marriage Blanket looks and feels just like a soft, warm comforter. But on the inside, it contains a layer of activated carbon fabric, the same type of fabric used by the military to protect against chemical weapons. Flatulence molecules
this
easily
real.
Pass through the cotton shell and are harmlessly absorbed into the layer of carbon fabric, even when used on top of bed sheets. Offending molecules are absorbed before anyone knows they're there. So whether you or your spouse suffers from a health issue or just the occasional disagreeable meal, you owe it to your marriage to try the Better Marriage Blanket. It makes a great wedding gift or anniversary gift too.
Great wedding or anniversary.
To order, call 1-800-981-1134. Just three easy payments of $39.95. Online at buybettermarriageblanket.com. Order now.
This is not much for a blanket.
For a queen size?
It's a lot. It is real. It is absolutely real. I'm looking it up right now.
And still just there? The still for sale?
Oh, yeah. Just because that you, like, just this idea that you have to be wrapped around and like you're a survivor of 9/11. You have to be wrapped in a sulfur-based fucking blanket just to hide your farts. I don't know what to tell you. You're asleep.
It only works as a sleeping bag because she's still under the blanket.
Yeah, but the thing is that it doesn't escape out from underneath the blanket.
Yeah, but she's under the blanket.
Yeah, but she's not her. It's not like her pussy smelling it.
No, but you throw it in a Dutch oven.
That's a good way. That's a good way to say it.
What is up
counseling
with the Dutch? Why do they fucking? Why are they farting in bed so much that we named it after them?
I think it's about covering it up. I think
It has to do with the Dutch oven cooking.
I thought you meant covering up the fucking Nazis.
Yeah. Fuck that. Ratline, baby.
You get the Dutch.
About rat lines one day. But I feel the problem is that if you're already like, because Natalie and I really aren't, again, people could be racist against me and assume that I'm fucking a farty guy, right? But I'm not that farty of a guy. I don't fart all that much.
Yeah, I'm
right?
a fartier I'm more, guy than you are, actually.
I just, honestly, I don't fart. I shit.
Yeah.
Right? And see, that's the thing.
You definitely shit. Right?
Yeah, I don't shit. Yeah. I fart.
Yeah,
you really don't fart that much. You know, I want to disagree and like call you out for farting, but like, I don't remember that many farts of yours.
I can't think of a single time when I've heard you fart.
Innocent. I don't fart. I don't fart as much, but
it's gotta be unhealthy.
No, I just shit. I'll shit 4 times.
Yeah, you shit a lot.
Yeah, he shits a ton. Yeah.
Every time we ever had a writer's meeting, we'd always start with him just shitting in the other room, and it would fucking ruin the whole meeting.
Yeah.
No, it's getting me ready to go.
Yeah.
It's getting me focused and in the game. It's why I'm so distracted right now, because of the violent lamb-based piss I am filled with to the brim. And you know what? I'm rock hard. Yeah. That's what they said at the top. That's why I'm not going to get up, because I have a full piss erection in the middle
piss
of the
hard
show.
Piss hard.
What's about a bit of British slang?
I am going to die. I feel like if you're one of those farty couples, a good way to test that is, so you got to wrap yourself up. It shouldn't be while you're sleeping. It should be when you're awake.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, speaking of poop and speaking of peeing, I got a video. Has both. Let's see it.
Oh, thank God.
Here, Sleazy Dan, why aren't there as underwear?
And I make her pee. Why? Because we're flipping psychos.
What?
Let's see it one more time.
Is that a blade villain?
Well, Sleazy Dan says, why not just make underpants out of the same material? And I think that they do. I think that they might.
She makes me poop. And I make her pee. Why? Because we're flipping psychos.
Yeah, I don't understand. I don't understand that, man.
I wish she made a Shreddies. Pee noise.
No, they do. Wow, they make a whole line of fart. This is a whole line of fart-based clothes called Shreddies.
Well,
pajamas, there's trousers, there's undershorts, there's bedding, there's a fart pillow that you could put under your chair so you could fart in your chair all day.
I appreciate that people go to these links, because there was somebody chronic flatulence
with
on
IBS.
The back. On the last flight I was on, someone with chronic flatulence that was foul. And everyone on the plane would have really appreciated if there was some sort of measures taken.
Mm-hmm. I've heard several members of our listening audience that have IBS that talk about farting hard and how farting is a curse that they are labeled with. And honestly, it sounds like it's going to be fixed.
They sell freedom.
IBS sell freedom. Is the shittiest TV station.
That's very, you know, you joke, but it's a serious condition.
I know.
It's a serious condition, and you have shamed them.
Oh, I didn't.
That's interesting.
About that. Look at him sticking his face directly in her ass.
What's going on with
that? Look at that. Wow. Wowie, wowie, wow. She's loving it.
She is loving it.
Yeah.
She's laughing like she's eating a salad.
It looks like he's loving it.
Yeah, he better.
He'd probably like it if she wasn't wearing the underpants, it seems.
I think it's better if she wasn't. Yeah, I think when it comes down to, because then you get straight to the hole.
So it seems like that's what he wants.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the idea is like, you know, everybody loves rimming, but nobody really likes it when someone's a super farty, crazy bitch, right? Mm-hmm. So you just want to make sure that they can fart it all out. And I guess before you get in there, you push down her belly from behind, and she gets as many farts out through the carbon as possible. Pull it down, blah, 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 blah. Put it back up. Then you let her fart out a little bit more, because again, it's just it's about the embarrassing thing of him getting farted in your mouth, and you become a big shitty blowfish.
Yeah, I've always been more of a rammer than a rimmer myself.
Yeah, ugh. I can see that. Oh, the car banana.
Zoom
Oh, the carbon. I thought I saw carbonara.
Carbonana.
Like, yum, yum.
Well, you're hungry.
Yeah, yeah, immediately. Yep, yeah. And that's also a racist thing I could say about you, about how your favorite meal is carbonara.
Wow. So it's, oh, it's just
Polish,
it's,
Ukrainian.
It slips right into your buttock. It slips right into the crack.
Oh, look at that.
Airport security scanners were unable to see through Shreddy's carbon cloth. And so wearing our garments when checking in is likely to cause you some hassle.
Yeah, I no, say the black one is probably better. You get the dark
colored
one.
Yeah, don't you? Yeah. I would do the peach colored one. Because, no, it needs to be dark as night. I actually prefer a mocha. I think a mocha would help. Yeah. I also think that guess what? That's not going to help, man. If they pull you for the additional screening and then they take you to the stupid machine where you got to stand like this, they're going to see that thing and you're going to have to pull that thing out. For sure.
I'd love to show it to them.
Definitely going to have to take
this
it out.
This is my fart banana. Fucking smell it, man. Peel it, baby. See what happens
honestly, this is my – having a fart banana would be such a good – and then just be like – this is my disability. And then we sue the airport. We sue the fucking, we sue everybody. All of a sudden, it is the Edward W. Larson Airport. You know what I mean? It's like that style, you know, like
how many
Edward
fart
bananas,
banana
Larson.
How many fart bananas do you think we can jam in Lizzo?
Whoa. Leave her alone. She's under already, she's under enough pressure. She took everybody to Amsterdam. It was a mistake.
So this next. So this next video, there's a lot going on in this video. There's a lot happening, and a lot happens in a very short period of time. So I want all y'all to see exactly what you can spot happening here. All
right, I'll shut up.
Hunter asked, can you tell my fiance Emma a happy birthday?
Happy birthday, Emma. Fiance Emma, happy birthday. Happy birthday, fiance Emma.
Happy birthday, Emma.
Does she want a fart banana?
Mm.
Fart banana, fiance Emma.
€20 for a fart banana, by the way.
That's
pounds.
It. It's that easy.
Pounds?
That was pounds.
That was pounds. Oh,
okay. 20 pounds for a fart banana.
Continue. Are they off the euro? That's right, they are. Yeah, Boris took them off.
Well, they never, I don't think they ever, they didn't fit. They would take euros, but they always kept the pounds.
They love taking money, those motherfuckers.
They do.
You know, the only place that's still on the euro is Greece. I have to go to the bathroom.
You have 3 minutes.
Euro. Take a euro.
A euro. No, I get it.
I need a euro!
Because you're hungry again.
I'm starving.
We're dying. I'm dying here. I'm dying.
All right. Let's see this one. All right. No sound.
Oh. Whoa. Oh, my God. Oh, my fucking God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Oh! Be careful,
bud. What the fuck happened?
He's stuck.
What? Oh, God. That's so fucking scary, dude.
Pandemonium.
There was no plan.
Watch. Chainsaw. Look. Calms down. Other fucking... The other...
Ladder
comes. The tree continues to fall. She falls.
Well, she got like, stuck by the chainsaw. She was halfway up the tree. You could tell what happened is that he didn't understand by the way the tree was that when he cut the thing, because it said it was held up by a fucking pole. It swung this way probably instead of going the other way, and it knocked the ladder out. That's fucking scary as fuck, dude. That's why I don't do manual labor.
I love watching tree trimmers. I can watch tree trimmers all goddamn day, but then, you know, I just feel like a bad person because I'm not willing to do it myself.
But that's fine.
It takes
admiring their skill.
That's a good point.
I went and did the same thing. I was sitting watching the guy trimmed my palm trees. He walked up to the thing, palm trees, and he shimmied up the thing. That was crazy. He went all the way up the thing, and he was him checking off the thing. And I just sat there watching him with a seltzer, just going like, "Woo!" That's been like, "Damn, dude!" Like it was fucking sweet. Honestly, it was a good show.
Very nice. That's very nice. Let's see a video with the duck.
Okay.
Don't do it, Jerry. Don't do it, Jerry. No, Jerry. Those were my grandma's ashes. Get out of the house!
Fucking Jerry, man. Always causing problems, Jerry.
I just love the idea that he could even get into the cabinet on his own as a duck. I can't get up there. So fucking funny. That's the thing, man. You feel like you should probably keep your ashes in a secured thing. Like, when you die, you're going to get... Did we talk about this? You're going to get cremated?
No, I'm going to get a grave. You're going to get a tomb, I'm going to get a grave, and you're going to get cremated, right?
Oh, I want to donate my body to the bodies exhibit.
That's nice.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
we're talking about
it. That's nice. Yeah, you want to pay your respects, $38.99.
Yeah, it's just you sitting there on a toilet.
There's a fucking food court and everything. That's Everyone's going to be happy. I'll travel around and shit. It'll be me playing volleyball. We'll have a good time. Me and a bunch of... I can finally get to hang out with Chinese people.
That's really nice.
All day long. It's just...
This pose.
Oh. Uh-oh. Henry's out.
Uh-oh.
What happened?
He disconnected himself. Oh, yeah.
Connect back up to it so you can fucking do this last minute. No, he's out.
This is very inappropriate way to end the show.
This is a very inappropriate way to end the show. This is terrible.
We've lost it.
This is absolutely terrible. I can't believe how unprofessional you are.
Yeah.
I can't believe this is where we've ended with this fucking travesty at the end of my goddamn mandate. Henry doing this bullshit. Yammering. Who knows what he's yammering on?
Fuck.
You know, I want to keep him here. I want to keep him here.
There's nothing. You hear nothing. You broke yourself.
Yeah. Great. Now he's frozen.
Right back?
There we go.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah, and the show's over, by the way.
I want it to be noted. I want it to be noted what I've done, how I've arrived. Now that the show is over, I can have some time to myself. All right. Mitch McConnell. Nude. There we go. Let's get her going. Here we go. Start. We're getting her ready. Oh yeah, this is gonna be a once in a lifetime move.